So welcome back to Pathology Lessons. We have completed the first unit, and the second unit it is about patterns of behavior. So for the from the first unit, what we learned about what is behavior. So these are a few definitions which was proposed by many ethologists and in the past. So the first definition, it is by Beck and others in 1981, and it says behavior is all the externally visible activity of an animal in which a coordinated pattern of sensory, motor, and associated neural activity responds to changing external or internal conditions. So this changing external or internal conditions is what is referred as a stimulus. So with respect to the stimulus, the animal, it shows certain behavior, okay, that some activity, and that is what is referred as a behavior. Fine. Now another definition which is given by Wallace and others, it is behavior could be defined as all the observable activity of an organism, anything an organism does that involves action or response to stimulation. Simple words. Similarly, you can see 1966 Davis definition for behavior. It says it as the way of an organism responds to stimulus. So what an animal does, that is what is behavior. Okay. So here we are going to learn the simplest of the behavior pattern, and the first one, it is simple reflexes. We have already, I hope you remember whatever we have completed in the first. Now the simple reflex, it is actually the reflexes which we have already learned with respect to the physiology classes in your class 12. Okay, here the reflex is with respect to behavior we are learning. It is an innate behavior, that is by birth itself the organism individuals show such this kind of behavior. So it is a simple inborn automatic response by a part of our body to a stimulus. So when a stimulus is given, the part of the body responds to that particular stimulus, and this actually behavior, it is inborn, stereotyped, that is, it is seen in the same way in all the individuals of this particular species. Involuntary response, so it has a greater thought process is not working behind. It is an involuntary sudden response, and it is simplest of the responses found in animals with nervous system. So when we speak about this one, it is usually found that reflexes could be an automatic response of a part of the body to a stimulus, and the response, as we already saw, it is they are inborn. Okay. Reflexes are often considered as the simplest units of behavior. The reflex which causes us to close our eyes when something flashes towards them. When something comes directly into the eyes, we just close our eyes, isn't it? So there is no thought process going on. It is involuntary and this fast response. That kind of a response is what is referred as a reflex behavior. And similarly, when we close our eyes, as soon as some dust particles enter the eyes, tears are induced automatically. So all those automatic responses, and these are inborn, that is by birth itself the individuals will be showing such kind of responses. There are two classes of reflexes based on the time pattern. That is a tonic reflex and phasic reflex. Tonic reflexes are relatively slow. They are long-lasting adjustments that maintain muscular tone, posture, and equilibrium. So it is kind of a postural maintenance. The reflex is shown for the maintenance of equilibrium, maintenance of posture, maintenance of muscular tone. So any behavior which is meant for maintaining the normal posture, equilibrium, and muscular tone is what is referred as a tonic reflex. Okay. Now, on the contrary, the phasic reflex is rapid. They are short-lived adjustments that deal with emergencies. That is a phasic reflexes. There are plenty of examples which we can see the phasic reflexes. For example, what happens if you step on a thorn? Okay, that is a reflex. We just take back the leg, isn't it? So what happens is we bend our legs, and that is a kind of the stretch reflex, isn't it? So that that's move, we bent our leg, and that kind of a movement is known as stretching. Okay, so stretch reflex, it is referred as stretch reflex. Okay, so that flexion we call it is. So here what happens is, it is for actually such kind of behavior. It helps the animals to respond quickly to a stimulus, and thus protecting them from any dangerous conditions or from any harm. Okay, so at its simplest way, a reflex involves receptor to receive the stimulus, a sensory neuron to carry the stimulus to the spinal cord or cranial centers, brain centers. And then an effective organ. Effective organ includes the muscles, or it may be a gland. Okay. For example, what happens when we step onto a thorn? That is, here we can see there is a receptor which pick up the stimulus. The pain receptors are there. Sensory neurons which pick up this stimulus and take it to the spinal cord. Then spinal cord brings about the the response, isn't it? The how to respond, that is decided at the spinal cord, and the motor neuron, it brings back the message to the muscles on the legs, and that is how we show the flexion. Okay, so this is what happens during the response. So tonic reflexes and phasic reflexes, it is based upon the time pattern, right? Then we can see that the reflexes, one example as we saw, it is a flexion, that is a you can see a figure, then it will be very a little more clear. Here you can see when we tap on the knee, when we get a tap on the knee, okay, so what happens, we show a movement, isn't it? So there is a knee jerk reflex we call. Okay, so there is a stimulus, that is a tap on the kneecap, the patella, and there is a extension. Okay, so this is a one kind of a reflex, that is knee jerk reflex, it's an example, right? And this is very sudden, no, very fast, isn't it? It is very fast. So what kind of reflex it could be? It could be the phasic reflexes. Okay, so is there any maintenance of posture, equilibrium, or muscular tone? Nothing like that. Okay, so here it is actually response to a tap on the kneecap, and this happens, and this actually results in the extension, right? That is, the leg is actually stretched out. Fine. Now another reflex is the tonic neck reflex. This is a slow reflex, actually tonic reflexes, as we have already seen. So in infants below 7 months or 6 months, you can see that when they turn the neck to one side, the arm on that side stretches out, while the opposite arm, okay, bends at elbow end point. Okay, this kind of a reflex is what is referred as a tonic reflex. Okay, so this one, it is very slow, and it maintains a posture, you can see over here, and it lasts only for 6 to 7 months. Okay, so after that, you can see it changes. So this is what is referred as the tonic reflex. I hope it is clear. Now, reflexes, it could be even cerebral reflex and spinal reflex, depending upon what part of the central nervous system the reflex is coordinated. Okay, some of the reflexes, like with respect to the turning of the head, closing of the eyes, they can be considered as cerebral reflexes because they are coordinated by the cerebral part of the brain. While some of the reflexes are like bending the leg or taking off the leg, all those could be the spinal reflexes. When we touch a hot object, what happens? We lift off the hand, isn't it? Those are the spinal reflexes, right? Now, reflexes usually perform some muscular or glandular responses, as we have already seen, and which is obviously to help the organism. Withdrawal of a limb when it is injured protects it from further injury and is therefore referred as protective reflex. Okay, it is for protection of the individual, the organism. But in contrast to the protective reflexes, reflexes can be postural or postural reflexes, which maintain standing and holding the head upright. For example, if someone jumps onto your back, what happens? Your knees buckle momentarily. It is just we may bend at the knee point, and then after some time your legs extend. Okay, so it restores the original posture. So that kind of like reflex is what is referred as a postural reflex. So normal posture is retained, right? So that is what is referred as a postural reflex, right? So the reflex is also referred as called the stretch reflex, because its stimulus is actually stretching of the muscle spindle. Right? So most of the simple protective reflexes involve action at the part of the body where stimulation occurs. So when one leg is pinched, for example, it is that leg only which is withdrawn. So in the course of evolution, those organisms survived which were best equipped with such kind of localized reflexes programmed in, by heredity, and hence passed on to next generation. And this could help to protect the body from injury and also help in maintaining the posture. So this is the most simplest kind of what you call behavior. An innate behavior occurs in all animals. However, they are less common in species with higher levels of intelligence. Why is it so? Because in those individuals, we can see that there are other kind of complex kind of behavior which have got evolved for their survival. So the only innate behavior seen in humans are the reflexes. For example, a human infant will grasp an object such as a finger that is placed on its palm. The infant has no control over, it is not voluntary, they have no control over this reaction, and hence it is a innate, inborn behavior. Okay. So this is a simple reflex. So these are the two examples of simple reflexes. Right. So the next one, it is instinct, that is again a what you call innate behavior. So we'll be learning it in the next presentation.